Okay guys, so are you guys able to see my screen, right? Okay, right. So guys, actually today, right, so first we are going to discuss about percentile, how we are going to find out the percentile, what is the formula actually behind that percentile. Okay, so let's assume actually just I'm going to give some. See here, I'm having, let's assume 5, I have some numbers 10, 12, 14, 16, 20, 25, some random numbers 30, 42, and 52, and 70. Okay, I have these numbers. Let's assume. So now, guys, so percentile actually. The formula for the percentile is, okay, P equal to N divided by N into 100 multiplied with 100. So this is the percentile formula. So here, what is the mean by N and what is this N? And anyhow, percentile, to give the percentage, right? So we are going to multiply with 100. So now we have to find out this. For example, now out of this case, so see, always you have to remember whichever the maximum value you are having, this 70 here, in our case, it is a 70. So for this percentile is 100%. The percentile is of this maximum value is 100%. Out of all these numbers, whichever we are having maximum value, that percentile is 100%. Now, I want to find out, like, 60 percentile or something, or like I want to find out what is the percentile for 42. Number 42, I want to find out the percentile. Now in this case, what I am going to do is just here small n means we have to count the number of records below or equal to 42. So there might be a chance you can see one more 42 here, right? One more, comma, 42. Now here in this case, you have to count the number of values equal to and below 42. Now here, if you'll count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 values we are having. So now here, P equal to 10 divided by and the total number of records. The total number of records is 12 here, correct? So here, these all are 10, and if you add 52 and 70, it is going to be 12. I'm multiplied with 100. So now, if you will perform this operation, then you are going to get the percentage. So now, if you'll do this one, what is the value we are going to get, guys? Let me open the calci. So here, 10 divided by 12. So the value is 0.83 multiplied with 100. So now the percentile of this value is 83.33. So this is the percentile, 83.33. See, now, for example, now in the calculation, in the tableau, what we are going to do is we are giving the percentile, right? So now let's assume here, create a calculated field. So here in this calculation window, for example, if you are giving percentile, now you are going to mention, for example, either quantity or whatever it may be, quantity. Now you are going to give like 0.4%. Means it is now you are trying to calculate the 40%. Now, whenever you will write this calculation, what is going to happen is, below 40%, whatever the values is there, it is going to find out all the numbers. Means the formula here, it is going to identify below 40% values. Okay, let's assume if you are having 40 numbers below this percentage. And after this, the number of values, let's assume 250. then multiplied with 100, then you are going to get this percentile, whatever it is going to give, right? So that percentile value you are going to get. So this is how the percentile is going to be calculated in the back end. Okay. Is it clear, guys, how percentile will be calculated? Okay, right. So now, right, so today we are going to discuss about the groups and sets. Okay, so in between, right, so after end of the session, I will give one scenario for you guys regarding the calculation. So try that one. Okay, try to find out the solution for that, whatever I am going to give. Okay. Now, right, so just I am going to explain you groups, what is the main purpose of groups, and how we are going to create the groups, okay, and what is the mean by set, and how sets we are going to use in real time, and groups as well. Okay, fine. Guys, group is nothing but combining similar kind of data members. Coming to definition wise, right, so group is nothing but combining similar kind of data members and creating a one high level data member. Now, for example, let's assume I have subcategories, different subcategories. Sorry, I am having different subcategories. And in these subcategories, let's assume I have different profits. Okay, each subcategory is having different profits. Now, if I will sort out, I am going to sort by descending. Okay, just this is the descending order. Now, here, right, so just I am going to create a one group. What my requirement is, negative profitable subcategories, I want to make one group. And like these are the loyal, medium profitable, and these are the high profitable subcategories. Just I want to create a one group. Okay, so I want to make one group. Then the amount, like the values I want to display in a single way. Now, right, so what is going to happen is how, first of all, how you are going to create group is here. You can create group in two ways. The first one is like, you can click on these marks. Here you can click on the marks. Now these are the three negative values. Once you will select by holding the control key, I have selected these three. And after that, you can see here, you can find the paperclip icon. So this icon means it is a group members, means by clicking this icon, paperclip icon, we can create a group. Now I am going to click on this. Now once I will click on this, now you can see it has been created as a group. Now you can see all these three values, whatever the negative profitable subcategories, whatever I have selected, it's added, it is showing a single data member. Okay, now low profitable, for example, 10,000, greater than 10,000, I want to make it. So now what I'm going to do is 6,000 I am going to select, and fasteners and labels, machines, paper is more, so I am not going to select. Phones is also more, so this is fine. Now here we are having another odd 6,000. So with this, I'm going to create another group. See, just I have selected, and again I am clicking on this group icon. Now you can see two groups. Now I am going to make everything is apart those two, everything I am making as a one group, that is a high profitable subcategories, means which is having greater than 10,000 profit. Now you can see I have only three groups. Now I want to rename it. So now this one I am going to make it, just right click on this and edit alias. Now high profitable high profitable subcategories. Just after entering the details, just click on it. Now here, this one I am going to edit alias again. Negative profitable subcategories. Again, these all are like medium profitable. Otherwise, low profitable. So this way you can create the groups. Now you can see how you, like what we have done here. Just you have not done anything here. Just as per the customer requirement, whatever the subcategories we are having negative profits, those subcategories we are showing as a negative profitable. Means what we are just, we are combining all the values, whichever the subcategories having negative profits, we are showing in a single row. And low profitable, below 10,000, whatever the subcategories is having below 10,000 profit, just we are making one group. Now guys, so after once you have created the group, now you can see under dimensions, you can see one more, like here you can observe this one, here this symbol. So this field has been created. Whenever you will create a group, automatically this field is going, one extra field is going to be available under your dimensions. The field is going to be, the field will have this icon, paperclip icon. Whenever you can see this paperclip icon, you can say it is a group. It is a group. So this is the one method. So the first method is by selecting the data members from the visualization, means marks. By clicking on the marks, by holding the control key, I have selected the marks which I want to make as a group. Just after that, I have clicked on the paperclip icon. So group has been created, right? So now the another way is, I want to create the group based on subcategory, same thing I am going to do. So now here, what I am going to do is just right click on this. Okay, right click on this and create group. Just right click on the subcategory, go to create option and select the group. Now you can see, once you will click on the group, now you can see you can see the subcategories, all the subcategories, whatever we have in the data set, right? So here I am going to give like some grouping of subcategories. Just I am renaming it. Now here, guys, from here, how you can create a group is, for example, now just randomly I am going to select this. So here I want to create one group with this subcategories. So just I am making only two. Okay, just after selecting this, just click on the group. Now you can see group has been created. Now I'm going to mention like some high. Okay, so guys, once, for example, if you are not able to edit it, so what you can do is right click on this, rename. See, okay, if you cannot double click it to rename it, so you have to right click on it and rename. And few more options. Whenever you are right-clicking, you can say add to ungroup. Now, for example, this one, for example, if you will right-click on this arc, now you can see add to option came, add to, you can click. So if you are having any groups, you can select that one and you can add it to that particular group. Now here, I'm getting high when I click on the group high, and add to when I will click on it. Now you can see already it is displaying high. Let me create another group with the tables. Okay, so now I have high and tables, two groups. Now if I will click on high and add to, now we can see high and tables. Now if I will select the tables and if I will click on okay, now we can see what has happened. Tables also added into this group. Now everything became one group. Okay, this is how you can add it. okay? Or else without creating group directly, what you can do is right click on it, add to, and you can select the group name. And if you want to ungroup them, right click on it, just ungroup. Or you no need to right click, so then you can click on it, just click on ungroup. Or renaming also you can do from here, rename. Okay, after selecting, you can do whatever you want. Just ungroup means now you can say everything is showing in a single place. There is a no group. So I am going to click on group again. Now you can see this group name, just recommended. So just I am giving recommended and rest all are not recommended. So if I will click this option, include other, just once I will click on this, now you can see the remaining whatever is outside of this, not part of recommended, everything is added into others. If I will remove it, now you can see automatically it is going to group the remaining things. Okay, this is how you can create a group. Okay, and find members. For example, if you are having lots of things, right? So you can find the member. For example, you can type, for example, tables. Okay, table, for example, contains, so find all. So now you can see tables is find, table is selected, and you can, what you can do is here, you can add it to, like for example, if you are having more values, then it is going to help you to find out the name. Or if you want to find out only starts with, you can type only B. For example, I am going to type with B. Now you can see find all means binders, bookcases selected, and exact match contains. So you can, based on these values, you can search if you are having more values. Okay. And find next means it is going to select one by one. In the like in the text, right? You can click on find next whenever you are searching by using Control F. Okay. You can click on find next. So that way it is going to work. Okay. After everything is done, what you can do is you can click on OK. Once you will click on OK, now you can see another field has been created. Another field has been created under dimensions with the given name, grouping of subcategories, whatever the name I have given. Now, if you can use this group to create for example, I want to find out the sales. Now you can see recommended and others. It is going to display this way. Okay. Now, if you want, right, so you can see the detail, like what is part of recommended and what is part of other, right? So then you can drag this category as subcategory as well. Now you can see under recommended, you are having these many subcategories, and others, you are having these many subcategories. Okay. See, specifically the groups, right? In the real time, actually, the customers are going to tell you what he want to see, like what kind of region sales or city sales, whatever you want, they are going to tell you, like, I want to see these four cities value in a single row. I want to keep some name for this. So they are going to tell you, accordingly, you are going to create a one group. The remaining as it is, you can show. Even, right, so instead of this, you can only mention recommended, and remaining everything you can show the same as it is. So right click on it. Sorry, not right click. So again, if you want to edit, means I don't want to keep others. I want to see the original subcategory. So I am going to click on this drop down, whatever the group I have created. Just I am clicking on this drop down and edit group. And after that edit group, just I am going to select this one and I am clicking on ungroup. Now after that, I am clicking on OK. Now you can say this is how you can display. See, the recommended is also included and the remaining separately it is displayed. So this is how you can group the data. And some other scenarios, guys, real time actually. So what is going to happen is, for example, while loading the data into your reporting tables, generally what is going to happen is, for example, you are having different regions. APAC, that is a one region, and so not something, just I am typing, guys. Okay, so and these are the two regions you are having, and you the data, right? So the daily the new data is going to be loaded into your database tables, whatever you are using for reporting purpose. Now, for example, sometimes the data is loading as a APAC, and sometimes APAC and APAC sometimes depends, right? So APAC something different, like this is how your data is coming into your table, final table. Then how your, like, for example, now if you drag the region, how many regions it is going to display? Is it going to be one region or it is going to be multiple regions with the same name? Mm-hmm. Are you sure? Yes, correct. See, if you are using Excel file, everything is going to be displayed as a one group. Remember that. If you are using Excel as a source, everything is going to be shown as a one name, APAC. Okay? But in general, in real time, we are going to fetch the data from database table. So if the database table having the names like this, automatically, you are going to get different names. Okay, let me show you one thing. So quickly, just connect. Okay, fine. So now, guys, so I'm going to connect to this database. The password has expired. Okay. Alter username followed by so download the SQL plus. Okay. Select username account status from username. That is fine. Alter user account unlock. Password identified. Sorry. Identified by. Missing or invalid option. Alter user. or invalid option. Okay, right guys. So here I am able to connect. So let me see. Let's go to properties. Oh, username is Tableau. Sorry guys. Username is Tableau. So that's why it is not working. Here the connection. Yeah. User is altered. So now I'm going to connect to this one. Now you can see here, I am having one table, guys. The table, I have like people groups. Yeah, something groups I have created earlier. Now, select. Select star from group sets. So this is the table I have created earlier. So just I want to see the things. Now guys, so you can see here, I have like EMEA, APAC, LATAM, NAMR. So these are the different regions I have. Okay. Now, for example, here I don't have anything. So let me add one more row. So here I'm going to add one more row. Insert into table value. Insert into table values. So here table value, first one is product ID. So product ID is already, we are having 130 products. So I am going to give 131.0 and comma. So now company code, I am going to give something like, okay, this way, or zero, comma. So again, product name. So product name, I am going to enter. I am going to enter in colons. So product name is mobile phone. So mobile phone, I entered. Then after that region, I am going to give like AP, AC, small cases I have given. And after this, so I am going to enter sale amount is 12,000, comma, profit is some 1200. Okay, so this is what I have entered. Just I'm going to run this query here. Invalid table name, invalid table name, insert into table. So here table means we have to use group sets, groups underscore sets. So this is that table. Column not allowed here. Column not allowed here. What is the column? Oh, sorry. A group set. This is the table, right? What is this? Insert into group set values error, column not allowed here, column not allowed here. What, where is this? Mobile phone. Mm-hmm. So something is different. So let me give everything. Okay. Let me see the properties of this space. So table columns. So everything is okay. So I have to give colons, guys. Everything I have to give the colons. I think it's not allowing double quotes as well. So that is the problem. So let me enter. Okay, So after this, just I'm going to insert it. Yeah, now you guys can see one row inserted, right? So now if I will run this table, now you can see there is a one region name with APAC with small letters. Now I'm going to connect to this Oracle database and I'm going to use this table for testing purpose, how it is going to display. Now guys, so I'm going to Tableau and I'm going to make a new connection, just new by clicking on this new data source option. I'm clicking on it and I'm going to select the Oracle database here. And here, this is the local host and everything I have given. And here, instead of this one, username, I am going to mention Tableau and password is also a Tableau. So I'm clicking on sign in. Now it is going to connect to connecting with Tableau user, whatever the database I have created. Now I'm clicking on select schema. Now in this, right, so whatever the schemas this user is having, right, so it is going to display all the schemas. Now here you can see here the schema, automatically it will load, guys, actually. Yeah, now you can see schema is Tableau and now the tables, whatever is available, it is showing here. Now I am going to drag this table here. Now here you can see whatever the data we are having in the table. So all the data is displaying here. Now you can see there will be a, and guys, one more thing here, you can observe here, like NAMR, row number 126, it is small letter, and 125, it is a capital letter. So already there is a one region with the small case. Okay, fine. Now guys, so I'm going to click on this. I'm going to sheet level. Now I'm going to drag the region, right? So once I will drag the region, now you can see here, it is displaying NAMR. Okay, here the problem is I want to commit. Otherwise it is not going to insert the record, right, permanently. So just I want to commit, just I'm clicking the commit. So now the data has been committed. Now here, if I will go to Tableau, if I will refresh it, now you are going to get one more APAC. Now you can see APAC is available. Now guys, in this scenario, actually, in these cases, you no need to wait for the customer to confirm, guys. In these kind of situations, you know, right? So APAC, there won't be any region with small case and one another region with uppercase. There should be only one region with APAC. So in these cases, what you have to do is you have to make this one as a common. Means you want to make this one as a group. So this time, right? So what you can do is you can right click on this, you can group it, you can group and you can give name as a APAC and NAMR. Okay, so this is a one scenario where you can work, but this one we can solve in different ways. Group is not the solution. These kind of situations actually, sometimes, for example, now APAC, small letters. Suppose, for example, the first character is capital A, second character is small p, and third character is capital, fourth character is small. Different ways the data may come, right? Now you have grouped it. So actually group is a static, it's not a dynamic. So dynamically, we cannot create the group. It is a static. Once you have created the group, let's assume tomorrow the data is inserted with like capital A, P, capital A, capital C, small c. So it is a different again. It is going to display as a new row. So this is not the case. Like if you are finding like only these two, this is a like, on the spot, you can create and you can give. But to permanently to fix this issue, what you have to do, right? So groups is a static. Groups is a static. For example, in these situations, we are not going to use the groups. That is not the better solution. Now, for example, in this case, the customer wanted to see, just I am going to remove this group, just right click on it. So here, ungroup. And here this one also, let's ungroup it. So now generally the user want to just add the group again, region, sorry. Here the user want to see the sales amount. Okay, here we are having a sales amount. Just I am making some because it is displaying as a, now you can see guys. So sales, automatically it is treating as a string because the data type of the sales in the database is a string. So that's why it is displaying sales and profit is displaying under dimensions. So now I want to convert this one as a measure. So now just I'm clicking these two and you can go to this dropdown and here convert to measure. Once you'll click on convert to measure, it is going to be converted to measure. Now you can see these two are measures. Now guys, so if I will drag this one now, okay. So here again, we are having a problem. Now if you'll observe here, the sales it is displaying as a count distinct. Is it like, do we need to count this one? No, right? We have to sum all these values. I'm going to, I did control Z. Now after this, I'm going to make it as a number decimal. Okay, now it is a number and profit also I'm making to number decimal. Now if I will drag, still it is going to display as an individual. So what I have to do now? So now if I will click on it, just convert to measure. Now you can see it is converted to a measure. Now it is not going to count. Once you will drag this one into text, it is giving a sum, right? So this is how you have to do. First, what you have to do is, guys, you have to change the data type from string to decimal or whole number. First, you have to change the data type. After changing the data type, what you have to do is you have to select the fields which you want to convert to measures. You can click on it, just convert to measure. Now it is, those are going to be available as a measures. Now you can use it. Once you will drag the these converted fields to measures, once you will use it, it is going to be aggregated by default as a sum. So this is what the values are. Now guys, so for example, the customer want to see different regions sales as a single sale amount. So in these situations, you can go with the groups. The customer want to see, for example, LATAM and NAMER or LATAM or EMEA. So he wanted to see these two region sales as a single region sales. Now, in this case, what we are going to do is we are going to create a group. So this is how you can create a group. Now, whenever you are getting EMEA or LATAM, automatically those are going to be included. The values, whatever the new records is getting added into your database, automatically the values is going to display here. Automatically it is going to increase. Okay. Here, once if you have created a group one time means automatically whenever the new data will come for EMEA or LATAM, automatically it is going to be available here. You no need to do manually again and again. But in these kind of situations, if the data is coming in different case sensitives, then it is each and every time manually you have to do. For example, let me show you an example. Now I am going to create a group, guys. I have created a group, okay? APAC and APAC. Now I am going to insert one more record in my database, okay? So here, just instead of, just I am going to mention capital A, capital P, and capital C. Okay, just I have mentioning this. So just I'm going to give 132. And just values I am keeping same as it is, just I'm going to insert. Now another row E got inserted into table. Just I'm going to click commit. Just I committed. Now let's go to Tableau and refresh it. Now, is it going to be included into this group automatically or not? In this case, it is not going to be inserted or not going to be added into this group automatically because we have done this one manually. Okay, now I'm going to click on this, just refresh it. Now it is going to display as a new name. Now you can see, this is how it is going to happen. This is not a complete permanent solution in this situation. Either in these cases, either if you can, from as a Tableau developer, you can do this one. So how you can do is, first thing, what you have to do is, either you have to convert all the regions into uppercase or lowercase. That is the one thing. So how you are going to convert? So you can write a one simple calculation to convert it. So I'm going to write a calculation, create a calculated field here. So I'm going to give name as a region. So I'm going to give one space here or one dot or one hyphen for identification purpose. So here we are having a functions called upper or lower. So we are having a upper. Now you can see, if I will type UP, automatically upper it is displayed. So if I am going to hit the tab button, that is going to be inserted. Now stream. So what we have to use? So we have to use the region. Now I'm going to select the region field. Now automatically, whatever the case it is having, automatically it is going to display automatically all. Now here we are having small case APAC. Now automatically it is going to convert into a capital A, capital P, capital A, capital C. All the characters, whatever we are having in the string, going to be converted into a uppercase. Now I'm going to click on OK. Now if I will drag this one, now you guys can observe here, we are having APAC, EMEA, LATAM. Now I am going to remove this one to avoid discontinuity. Now you can see we are having only four regions. This is what the customer is expecting. Now whenever, whatever, like however the data get inserted into our database table, we no need to worry now. We have converted to uppercase. Then automatically, if it will find any small case letter, right, automatically it is going to convert. Now in this case, whatever the data we are showing, this is correct. Okay, this is the one approach. Okay, or you can ask your database guy to convert it. But again, that is they have to do some analysis and they have to convert it, right? Instead of that, we are doing in Tableau level itself. So, okay, guess you got the difference, like when we have to use, when we cannot grouping. So this is the different scenarios case. And the grouping, right? So as I said, group is a static. It is not going to be updated automatically. And one more thing, for example, if you are, see groups, right? So if you are having, like for example, customer asked you to create a group, dynamic grouping based on some codes. Okay, like for example, let me go to here, Tableau, database. So let me run this table. Yeah, here guys. So let's see here, we are having different products, right? Different product names I am having. So in these different products, yeah, here you can see guys. So complete HP N5. And any other things, turn signal or blinker. Now here, mobile phones, well, this is two which I have created. Knife, surgery, aux, relay, complete HP. Yeah, here, so just here, window, mirror, headlight. Yeah, headlight here we are having. And yeah, windshields, window. Yeah, now guys, so wherever I can see wind, mirror and turn signal, right? Window shield, something. So wherever I can see, just I want to group them automatically. If wherever, like if this is the best example, guys, this is the best example. So complete HP N5, complete HP N6. Yes. Actually, right, so generally if we will talk, right, so there will be different versions, right? So if we'll take any vehicle, okay, so like the name will be same, like for example, if we'll take like any one bike product, like Yamaha, okay, Yamaha version 1, V.0, version 2.0, Yamaha VX, like this, the names will be different, right? But the product is Yamaha product. But in that, we are having different versions, right? So now the customer want to see, instead of different versions,
Now here in this example, complete HP N5, complete HP N6. This is, I think, right? So these are the two different versions with the same, right? So now in these cases, I want to automatically, whenever it will find complete HP N7 or something, or N4, the new version of this, automatically it should be added into that group. So in these situations, now here, till here, complete HP, till we are having common, right? So in this case, we can create a dynamic groups as well by writing the calculations. Now, let me try to create a one group here, okay? Now, let's go to Tableau. So here, I'm going to drag the product name here. Now here, guys, so if you will do manually grouping, so it is not going to work out again. So complete HP N5, complete HP N6, if I will right click and if I will create a group, it is going to be one time. If the new product will come with complete HP N7, it is not going to be added automatically because always groups are static. Now I want to create a one dynamic group thing. So how we can create, let's see. Now I am going to write only for these two guys, okay? So just create a calculated field. Now, I am going to give name as a product category. Here I am going to, if starts with, I am going to use starts with, okay? Now we have to give string substring, okay? Here, what is the string? What is the substring? Guys, always remember, string means the field name, okay? Product name means from product name, we are going to give the substring, okay? Now I am going to give the substring. What is the substring here? I am going to mention this complete HP. This is the name I am going to do here. So here I am trying to copy this one. I am going to click view data. I'm going to click view data. Now here from here, let me try to copy. Control C, copy. Now I am going to enter here. Means guys, whenever you are giving substrings, right, always it should match with this, okay? Just I am going to remove this one. Now I'm going to close this one. Now wherever, if it will find the substring with the starting of complete HP, means always in the product names, wherever it will find, it will starts with complete HP, automatically it is going to group, okay? If starts with, then guys, always in if statement, if then what? Else if, then what? Now here, then what I want to display? I want to display the name as complete HP. So this is the name what I want to display. And here after this, I want to else I'm going to give the product name. So what I'm trying to say here is if wherever in this field, in this product name, if the product name is going to starts with complete HP, then it is going to be treated as a complete HP product. I'm going to mention product. Wherever it will find, automatically it is going to be added into this, or automatically the remaining names is going to be displayed as this. That is what it means. Okay. Now I am going to click OK. Product category. Now you can see the calculation, whatever we have written is valid. Here, guys, wherever it will find complete HP starting with, automatically it is going to add this group. Means this is the name what I have given. This is going to be displayed instead of complete HP N5, complete HP N6, it is going to be displayed as a complete HP product. Now, from now, it is going to be displayed with this name. And the remaining things, if the products which is not starting with this name, the remaining products is going to display as it is. There is a no change on that. Is it clear, guys, the calculation, what it is going to do? I'm going to click on OK. Now here, if I will drag this one, now you can see I'm going to keep in front of product name. Now you can see complete HP product. It is now, now you can observe, guys. So it is going to be, now these two are part of this one, complete HP product. If I will remove this one, now you are going to get only complete HP product. So this is how you can automate this one. Now, if I will insert HP, like complete HP or something, whatever it may be, whatever I'm going to enter, then automatically it is going to be added into that group. Okay. Now let me add it. So here I'm going to make it like 134, 133. And here I'm going to enter mobile instead of mobile phone. Complete HP N6. COMPLEATE HP N6. Okay, so I'm going to insert this one. One row is inserted. And I'm going to insert N2 as well. Now let's see what is, I'm going to change this 4. Now I'm going to insert it. So guys, now you can see I have inserted total 2 records. Now you can see, you can find out complete HP N6, complete HP N2. Now if you'll refresh the Tableau, what is going to happen is, now let me add the profit as well. So let's see. So now you guys can see, for this profit is 32,60,000, right? So now once I will refresh, I have to do commit, guys. In SQL, I have to do commit, right? Commit is done. So now let's go to Tableau. So now here I am going to refresh it. Once I will refresh, now you can see it is going to be increased. See now, 2,400 something, it is increased. Because profit we have given only 1,200 for each record. Now if I will drag the product name, original product name, now you can see complete HP product is having complete HP N2, complete HP N5, complete HP N6. And one more product we haven't, right? I think it is included only one. Where is another one? Okay, let me go to here. Oh, sorry guys. So N6, I have added and N6. So now here you can see the complete HP N6 we are having. This is the profit amount and automatically now this is going to be added. 1200 is added to here. Now 166,200 it is going to display in Tableau. Yeah, this is what it is displaying. Means complete N6, right? So it is, it came 2 times, right? So automatically it is added into the here. Okay. So that's where you can see the total price of, total profit of that product. Is it clear, guys, how we can use dynamic, how, where we can use the dynamic grouping? Yeah, please. Yeah, good question. Now guys, so here itself, just I'm going to add the count. So your doubt is, now here we have created a dynamic grouping by using some calculation. Now here it is displaying as a 3 products. Now if you make the count of products, is it going to be counted as 1 or 3? That is your doubt, right? Right. Now I'm going to keep this one as it is. Now I'm going to do count here itself. I'm going to measure count and I'm going to make it discrete. Now, how many it is displaying? Complete HP products, it is displaying 4, right? 4 records. Why it is displaying 4? Actually, it is displayed as a 3, right? Now, let me drag the here product name. It is displaying 3, right? Why it is displaying? Exactly. Now, for this complete HP N6, we are having 2 entries in the database. So that's why it is counted as a 2. So if I will make this one as a count distinct, then you are going to get only three. Now, if I will remove this one, now it is going to display only three records, right? So is your doubt is clear? Right. So any other doubts, guys? Right, guys. So simple, if whenever, if someone will ask what is the mean by group, means the grouping, we are going to use the group functionality by combining the data members to make a higher level categories. That is a definition wise. Okay. Groups are static. Okay. If they may ask like, is it possible to create a dynamic groups? Yes, it is possible by writing some calculations. By writing calculation, but whenever we are writing a calculation, whatever the string or whatever it may be, based on that string, either starting with or contains whatever the substring the customer is giving, based on that we can create a dynamic groups. Otherwise, it is not possible. Is it clear, guys? Here also, let's see, complete HP, that is the substring what we are using to make group, right? If we don't have a complete HP, then it is not possible. Means complete may come from different places. This complete HP, for example, here in this first row, if complete HP available in here in between, then it is not going to consider, because we are using starting with function. Means wherever the string is starting from complete HP, then that is going to be group. Otherwise, it's not. Right? Clear, right? Right, guys. Fine. So this is all about the group space. So you got some idea, right? So what is the main purpose of groups? In which scenario we can use? Okay. And one more example. Let me give one more example. The customer wanted to see the for example, let's assume it is you are working for a client where some other team dealing with the incidents, okay, or the project is like a support project, okay. Normally they are providing the support to the business end users, business users. Actually, business users, whenever if they are facing any issue, they are going to log a one ticket, right? They are going to raise a ticket. Either Jira or like ServiceNow or whatever the ticketing tool they are using. Now let's assume all these tickets are the severity, priority of the tickets. Everything is managing in the database. And now the business owner want to see the different priority levels, means in each priority, what are the different, how many tickets is created. Like normally, generally, we will be having priorities P0, P1, P2, P3, P4, and P5. These are the different priorities and depends on the project and their whatever they discussed initially when starting the project, okay? They may have like P1, P2, P3, or it is going to start with P0, something, okay? Or S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, like this, okay? That is depending on the project. Now, here, P0 means very critical, so 100% users are impacting because of this issue. Means it should be resolved within hours. And P1 is like, it is also critical. It is going to have some time, like 4 hours or something. Okay. In this case, whenever the P0 will come, you guys have to rush and you have to fix that issue as soon as possible. Okay. Now P2, P3. So P2 also some important. And from P3 also, little bit like we will be having 3 days time. And P4, P5 is negligible, guys. Generally, it is not impacting much business, but they're expecting this kind of this issue should be fixed. Okay. Now the customer want to see
the priority is P0, P1, P2, P3, and others. Or we can include P3 also into others. Now, if you want to see the count, for example, here 100 incidents, they logged here 125, and here, for example, 400 incidents logged. Now, here, for example, for P3 also, we are having incidents. So that is,
one second, please.
So here, for P3, I'm having like 400 again. And for P4, I am having like 100. And P5, I am having like 120 incidents, like this. Now, guys, now the customer end user, he is not at all bothering about this because it's not impacting business that much. Okay. But because of these issues, the business is impacting a lot. Means now the customer want to see how many P0s, how many P1s, and how many P3s, how many P2s, and the remaining you want to display as the others. Now, in this case, what we are going to do is we are going to create a group for P3, P4, P5 manually. There is a no need because always P3 is come as a P3, P4, P4, P5, P5 only. So here we are going to create a group others, and we are going to display the count as 520. Okay. Now these three are not going to be displayed as an individual. Like this is how we are going to display the. Now here in these situations, we are going to use the group function, right? Grouping, manual grouping. Is it clear, guys? It's a simple example. Right, guys. So this is all about the groups. Any doubts, guys, on the groups? Right, guys. So now let's go to sets. No, we are not, we no need to go. Because right, P3, P4, P5, it's a standard names. It is not going to change and no values is going to come. Like P6 is not going to come. Those values, whatever, P0 to P5, that is a static. So that's not going to change. So we are not going. Okay. Okay. So now guys, so. And here, now we are going to learn sets. Okay. What is the use of set actually? So how we are going to use the sets in real time? Okay. So actually, definition wise, if you go, what is a set mean means? It is nothing but a subset of data. Set is nothing but a subset of data by using some conditions. Means by using some conditions, we are taking some set of data from the data source data. For example, for that, to justify that one. So actually here we are having different product names, right? Here we are having different product names, right? Here we can see different product names, right? Now I want to bring the product names which profit is having more than 1 lakh. Which profit is having more than 1 lakh, I want to bring that one. So how we can bring it? So we can use the sets in these scenarios. Now, for example, here I'm going to create a one set. Yes, let's see, just product name. I'm going to click on the product name, drop down, and go to create and set. Once you will create on a set, once you will click on the set option, now you can see one pop-up window is opened. In this window, it is giving name, general condition, top. Okay. Now, my requirement is I want to bring the product names which profit is having greater than 1 lakh. Now here, what I'm going to do is, just I am going to select the top and here, sorry, condition and here by field, I'm going to select. Here I am going to select the sales and some aggregation, and here I am going to select greater than or equal to 1 lakh. Okay, this is a 1 lakh. Now I am going to click on OK. Now here you can see, whenever you will create a set, it is going to be added one more extra field with this icon. This is the icon, set symbol. Generally guys, so I think, right, so in graduation, we have learned about the different sets, right? Set concepts. If you remember, like, yes, correct, exactly. That is what set here as well, okay? Okay, so now here, the set has been created. Now, if I will drag this set, actually, this set is going to give Boolean values. It is going to give Boolean values, either true or false. Here, it is not going to display true or false. It is going to display in and out. In and out. Always, the set is going to give in and out options. Set will give in and out. In or out option. So what does it mean by in here? In means whatever the condition we have given. We have given one condition, right? The condition is greater than or equal to 1 lakh. Now, in means the products which satisfies the condition, which satisfies the condition, those will fall under in. Those will fall under in. And out means whichever the products is not met the condition, those will fall under out, vice versa. Yes, is it clear? In means the products which satisfies the condition, means product which is having 1 lakh profit, those will come under in. Out means opposite to in. Means the products which not satisfying the condition, those will fall under out. Now, here we can say in means true, out means false, right? In means the condition satisfied one, out means false. Now, always remember sets will give Boolean results. Now, if I will drag the product's name set here, now let's say it is giving in and out. What does it mean by in? As I said, the products which satisfies the condition. Now, let me drag the product names. Now, if you will drag the product names here, now you can see these are the products which satisfies the condition. And only mirror is out in out section. So, is it really true? Now, let's go to here. Now, let's see how many, like, yeah, everything is, headlight. But guys, I think, right, so I have given the condition as 10,000, I think it's not 1 lakh, right? Yeah, 1 lakh only I have given. Now here, mobile phones and mirrors and everything is there, but it's not coming. Let me cross-check this one. So let's, I am clearing the screen. Yeah. Now here, product names we have given. Oh, sorry, guys. So here, let's observe, guys. Mistake, what the mistake we have done? We are using sum of sales. But here, with what we are checking? Sum of profit. So this is the issue. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make this one as a profit. This one as a profit. Now, if I'll click on apply, here you can see how many are below 1 lakh? 1, 2, 3. Three products, right? So if I will click on OK, now if you'll go to sheet, now you can see total four products were there. So these are the four products which is showing out. Now let me drag the profit here. Now you guys can observe, guys. So see, window is 150,000 and out is like 10,000, 5,000, 2,400 and 1,200. This is
is set actually the functionality of the set. It is going to give in and out. Means whatever the conditions we have given in the set, those are going to be whichever the products is satisfied the condition, it is going to be added into in, and whichever the products is not satisfied the condition, it is going to be added into out. Okay, is it clear guys till now? Right. Now we are having different sets guys. So it generally in sets, right? So we can say a static set. Okay, we are having a static set, or we will call it as a constant, and another one is a dynamic set, and the final one is a combined set. So actually, what is the mean by static set and how we can create it? What is the mean by dynamic set and how we can create, and what is the combined set? We are going to see now. Now guys, so first we are going to see what is the mean by static set. Now guys, static set means just let's observe the name static. Static means whatever you are selecting first time, the values is not going to change, correct? Now here I am going to create a one set. Like for example, I am going to take, again I am going to drag the product name here, product name, and I am going to drag the profit. Okay, let's assume profit. Now guys, so here what I am going to do is, in the case of let me convert into a bar graph. So let me sort it down. Yes. Now guys, so now what I am going to do is, I am going to select the marks by holding the control key. I am going to select the marks whatever is I required. Okay, I am going to select few, and after selecting few, what I am going to do is, right in the tooltip itself, you can see after the group icon, we are having the set icon. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to click on this arrow mark which is available here, create set. Okay, now I am going to click create set. Once you will click on create set, now it is, now you can see the products in this set, the members 7 total, means the members, data members, whatever we have selected, we are having 7 data members, means here we have selected 7 marks. So now I'm going to, now I'm going to give name for it as a static set, and I am going to click OK. Now guys, now here you can see this set, wherever you can use this set, these the values whatever is part of the set in section, this is not going to be changed. For example, let's assume in the database there were a couple of products, new products added into your database table, means here, right? So we are having a lot of products. In this, there were a couple of products added into this list. If the list will be get updated also in Tableau side, this section is not going to be added with the new products. Means this is a static set. Means the products, whatever we have selected here manually, always it is going to have only this product. Here you might got some doubt. What about these values? The values will get updated. No issue on that. The values for this converter and window, headlight, mirror, mobile phones, complete HP N2. So for all these products, the values will change according to database. If in the database side, if another the value will may change, right? The value, for example, now let's assume we are having 12,000 or 1200. In future, tomorrow, the value might be get increased to 20,000. Now it is going to display 20,000. That is not a problem. But the list, whatever we have selected, the product names, these product names is not going to be updated. Not going to be updated means not, I'm not talking about the renaming.
I am talking about the list. Whatever the data members, whatever the products we have added here, this list should be always same. Means now from here, Timmer is not going to be added automatically here. And also this whatever is in out section, it is not going to be included into in section. And if the newly added products, So if let's assume the new products is added into our database table, then the new products will automatically fall into this out section. Automatically, the new products will automatically get added into your out section, not into the in section. That is a static set. Always the products will be same. It is not going to be get changed. And one more thing, if the products make, if for example, let's assume the record converter data is get deleted from your database, then it is going to be removed automatically from here. Okay. So this is the static set. The static set means whatever the values initially you have selected, means whatever the data members you have selected initially, those data members will not, the new data members will not get added into your list. Always the list, the selected list will be static. It is not going to update with the new data members. That is this mean by static. Is it clear? Right. Now, how to create a dynamic sets? Okay. So this dynamic set means, dynamic means dynamically, automatically the data get should be updated based on the condition, whatever we have given, right? So let's assume here, now I'm going to create a one set, dynamic set. So what I'm going to do is, I am going to right click on this product name again. I'm going to right click on this product name. Or already we have used this product, right? Already we have created product name set manually, right? Now I'm going to edit the same set. Just click on edit. And here you can see, I have given the condition, right? Based on this condition, if whatever the products will satisfy this condition automatically get added, right? Now here I am going to give, like for example, 3 lakhs, okay? Now the list will change. Okay, I'm going to click OK. Now if you go to sheet here, okay, sorry, here itself. Now I am going to remove this one. Now I am going to add this product name set. Okay, now you can see guys, here sum of profit, right? So here you can see the products, like here till we can take 10 lakhs guys. Okay, 10 lakhs I will update, edit. So here I am going to add 10 lakhs. I updated. Now you can see the list automatically is changed. Below 10 lakhs is fall under out, and above 10 lakhs is fall under in. Now here, let's assume one more product get added into your database, and the profit of that product is 10 lakhs 1 rupee. Then what is going to happen? It is going to be fall under in or out. Automatically, that product will get added into in because this is a dynamic set. This is a dynamic set. So dynamic set means the it is going to work based on the condition whatever we have provided here. Based on this, it is going to work. So, one second, guys. So, yeah. Right. So, based on this condition, automatically the newly added data will also be added either in or out. Based on this condition, it is going to work. Now let me see, I'm going to add one field here, I'm going to insert one row, okay? And I'm going to give profit as here, right? So This is 1 lakh, right? Yeah, I am going to give 1. Okay. Yeah, 10 lakhs, 1 rupee I have added. And here I am going to give name as a 135. And I am going to give name as a, some my name I am going to give, okay? Something, okay? So now I am going to run this query. I am going to insert. Now I have inserted, and after that I am going to give the commit. Now I am going to check in Tableau. Now I am not doing anything, guys. Just I am closing it, okay? Now if I will refresh it, let's see what is going to happen. Now you can see Krishna is added automatically into your inset. It's not fall under out because the condition, whatever the condition we have given, that is satisfied. Is it clear, guys? How dynamic sets will work? Okay, so always the sets is going to give in and out. Okay, just remember that one. Now this is the overall products. Now generally these sets, right, we are going to use in filters. Okay, now if you filter it out, right, now by default you can say automatically you are going to get in data. Automatically you are going to get in data. Now if you see here, if you edit this one, if you click on show set, okay, sorry, hide card. Now if you click on edit filter, now you can see, guys, so 1 second, guys, so it is show in and out. Okay, so now you can see, guys, in and out we are having options. So if you click on in and out, automatically it is going to display everything. And here, guys, so we are having two options. Here we are having two options. One is show in and out set, means whenever you will select the option, this option, it is going to give in or out option to select. Either user can select either in or out. Now you can see here, I'm going to click show filter. Now here you can see the end user is going to get this option, either in or out. The customer want to see the in products, which is satisfying the condition greater than 10 lakhs. These are the different products. If I will select the out, it is going to give the remaining products, which is not satisfying the condition. And we are having here one more option, guys. So show members in set. If you click on show members in set, it is going to give the list of values. Okay. Now this is giving like outset values. Now I am going to click OK. So guys, now I am going to click on show filter. Now you can see it is displaying the in values, which is satisfied the condition. Okay, this is what it is displaying. Now, for example, okay, I don't want to go there. Just again here, right? So how you will get all the values? How you will get all the values, in and out values? Guys, so what you can do is, you can edit the filter. Here, select from the list. These are the values automatically selected. Now, if you'll go to use all values, now you can see what is going to happen. Still, it's not okay. All values, it is already selected. So here, I'm going to give in and out. Both I have selected. Sorry, guys. Again, in it selected. Edit filter. So I'm going to select in and out. Okay, it is giving both. Now, let me show set. So these are the different values which we are having, and you can see the condition also here it is provided. So means greater than or equal to 10 lakhs. Now here you can use this set in the color shelf as well. Now you can see, you can do the differentiate. You can show the differentiate, like whichever, whatever it is displaying. Like now if I will use whatever satisfied the condition, it is displaying in blue color and remaining are displaying in gray color. So if you can differentiate between them by showing both. Okay, so this is how you can display the data by using sets as well, guys. And also, guys, in sets we can do lot of things. By using sets we can do lot of things. Okay, so I will explain these concepts tomorrow, guys, because I have some other work. Okay, is it till here? Is it clear, guys?